That's what came out of me. Turn me up. When I got up on the 360 and turned around, the rim was right there.
That was nuts.
It looks, I'm creating stuff and making them?
Oh, my God. I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Up in the left hand doing all this.
With Larry Hughes of the Philadelphia 76ers.
Oh, Larry. I'm going to tell you what's so crazy about seeing this. First of all, he got the and-ones on as well. Which nobody gives him any love. And he get him.
He kicked that out.
I just,
When he missed it, I'm like, man, look, I can gotta let you know I'm at the crib. I know Larry since we was in high school. I'm like, come on, bud. So, you know, when he missed it, I'm like, that's a tough way to start when you miss him. Super athlete, though. Look how big Kenny's suit was.
Come on, man. It's our time.
Hey, look, this man, his dunk contest was crazy underrated. He went crazy.
And to hear you say that and to know for a fact that he did not want to do this. He didn't want to do this. This was
What you thinking right there when you see him, like, cause that's like, he did that, like, that was a run-of-the-mill thing. That was crazy.
I said, turn me up. This is why I wanted him in a dunk contest. See, listen to T-Mac talk, he's like, bro, I was dunking for second. But I look at it like, bro, if I don't make my dunks, I got to compete with this. You know what I'm saying? Like, I knew Stevie Franchise and Stack and all the other athletes, Tricky Ricky Davis and whatnot. But I'm like, I look at it, I knew who I had to compete against because I saw it every day with Matt. And it was like literally on the ride over there, Q, he was like, bruh, like our ride was late.
Tell me about the ride, how y'all was late and how you wasn't loose. You didn't get the warm up or nothing. Tell us that. Tell the people the backstory.
So our ride, we walk out. You know, they tell us what time we gotta be there. Man, first of all, look at this man. He just threw it from anywhere. Bro, like, he just threw it and like, all right, let me just go ahead and just throw it and take off. You know, a little warm up. And see, mind you, I'm sitting here and I'll go back to that story, but I'm sitting here right now watching these dudes like, all right, my dunk's not gonna work. I gotta come with something better. Like, I'm thinking this because, like, you know, you talk to other people, they're like, all right, you know, you gotta get a dunk, make a dunk, a little warm up dunk, you know, just to get yourself going. And I'm like, cool, but like, my warm up dunk gotta be a little different than everybody warm up dunk because I wanna set the tone. Because when you're in the middle of the pack, Larry Hughes had a chance to set the tone. Okay, he did.
Right.
Matt comes and sets the tone. Franchise comes after that and kind of takes it to another level. So what am I supposed to do? Like, I gotta follow that. You know what I'm saying? So that's where all of that comes from.
That's where adrenaline comes from, huh? Where you at right
on top
now?
Of looking around
right
everywhere.
There, what?
Right here. First of all, I got chills right now, just like I had then. And I'm still plotting. I don't know what I want to do. And the last
time
I
walked
this
down?
Off, yes, because the last time I tried this dunk cue, I barely made it. The last time I tried this, prior to this, I barely made this dunk. But I was so turned up. That's what came out of it. You see what I'm saying? So, and the crazy thing about it is, when I got up on the 360 and turned around, the rim was right there.
Yeah. He's looking at it.
So I said, this is what we doing. So I threw it through. So in my mind, the warm-up dunk, that's what you see. That was a deep breath, like, whoo, Lord.
That was all about to ask you. When you to tell me this, did you really, like, understand what just happened in that deep breath? Like, did you have to look back up and take a look at what you did?
Yeah, so, like, man, because I'm thinking, bro, I was, like, barely making this dunk. And like a whole bunch of like emotion and adrenaline came out because I was like hyped for the moment. I've been looking for this since I was a kid.
Yeah.
Now I'm here. I'm not blowing this moment. I'm coming to show off and show out. But like when I got right here, I see the rim. I'm like, boo. And then look, I could probably. I was
that,
so hyped.
The extra jump is when I knew. Oh, the extra man, jump let me know, like, oh, this boy turned up right now. Then post stack dollar. He had to come. He did a record. It didn't matter what he did. He could did a backflip. It wouldn't have been. It wasn't gonna hit the same way, bro.
Q, it take for you to hear Grant Hill's story, because he was the guy. Like, he looked at Stack. He's like, "Sure, you want to do this?" He told me that, bro. Like, I was losing it, man. I was like,
"What you gonna I was do in the after zone, that?" Bro. Now you just had the roof come off the play with the first dunk. And you got, you know, you don't know it, but you got Kenny Smith on the broadcast. It's over. It's over. Like, and then Stackhouse got to go do something.
And see, like, that's, like, that's, and Ricky Davis, man, Ricky Davis was doing some stuff too, man.
I was about to say, this was sneaky crazy right here. He did some, I'm telling you, Tricky Ricky was out there. He did some stuff. He wasn't like, it was just, you had already took all of, you had it by now. It's over with.
Man, I was trying to snatch the air out of the room there. But Ricky did some stuff, though. That one. But he got the other one from he did from behind. But so leading to all of that, so having to use a teammate, we were late. Our ride was nowhere to be found. So we ended up talking one of these drivers into taking us. Mind you, we weren't in Oakland. We were in San Francisco. So we had to get across the bridge. You know how that is from San Francisco to Oakland. So we still had to get there. We were supposed to have been there probably by the time the three-point contest started. Which gives you time to practice. We got there damn near to finals. When we got there, they're like, hey, practice time is over. And that's what Matt said. This is it. This is a sign. So I'm tripping, like, bro, what I'm going to do? What I'm doing? Then they said, oh, you know you got to use a teammate. What you mean you got to use a teammate? We never practiced this.
Bro.
We never practiced this.
Don't need to practice when you get the athletic gene and y'all family, clearly practice is not necessary. This is crazy.
But see, I hear you, but here's what I'm thinking right here on it, right before. Bro, don't mess this man dunk up.
Anytime you got to be a team, man, you don't want to mess up for nobody.
Especially in this situation.
So, well, y'all going against each other too.
Right. And so in my dunker's mind, I'm thinking, bounce the ball high, not low, so he get up higher. But like, bro, that's a two-hand windmill.
From grabbing it up high, then bringing it back down.
Then bringing it down, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So that's why I want the ball to get its high spot, but not too high where he can't reach it. So I'm like, all of this is thinking in my mind, don't mess this man dunk up.
What's the most asked question you get about this particular night, this dunk contest?
Did the arm in the rim hurt? Was probably the number one. Yeah, it didn't hurt that night. I'll tell the story when it comes up. But it didn't hurt that night. This is crazy.
That was nuts.
It looks simple, like on video, but like, he is for real flying.
And he's the smallest dude in the dunk contest. That's what makes it special. He give you that feeling like he just flew for a second. He flew across
for real.
Look at Ken.
Like, leaning. Look, I mean, it's
laid
this
out,
a better
like
angle.
That lean layout is different. Like, that's what getting style points to it, because he's laying out on you.
Look at that.
Touch the side of his shoe with it.
Yeah, man. Like, this is what I live for. This kind of competition, it wasn't like nobody laying down. Steve, you heard his comments. I don't know if you heard his comments after. He felt like he should have won. He wasn't laying down. You know, so I knew. I was like, man, look. What I was trying to accomplish with this is I wanted to show that I could take one step, do a windmill, going away from the rim,
and still
here's the one step. One. Look
and
at
you
the rim.
The wrong
away,
way, though. Still, the wrong way, though. That wasn't an easy way. You told me you can't jump the other way. That's the craziest thing ever. That's the craziest thing ever. He can't jump the normal easy way. He jumps the harder way.
Yeah, because me being, and let me tell you, I was so hot. Like, I tried to play it off, camera on my face, but like, all I could say, yo, he got me. I was hot with Kenny. Mind you, I had just done his camp earlier. Oh, here we go. This is what Grant had me laughing about. And they missed it.
Hey, hold up. When they thought about doing that, though, that was like when Nate Robb tried to step on Wilson back. Well, who else? Who did the Allen Houston? Remember Allen Houston did the cartwheel?
Yes.
This is on par for that. Look how fast G Hill got down.
Hey, G said he was trying to get low enough so he didn't trip, clip him, and he fell.
Nah, this is the end of round one.
Yeah, that's the end of round
one. Was it an element that you had to, like, you did want to save, like, some of the mother dunks, so it was like, I got to, or you was just coming off the dome?
I scrapped my whole dunk, my routine.
That was crazy right there. Like, look at the reaction. This ain't no look at the
people
reaction.
Understand how
no
hard
game.
That is to do.
That boy brought that thing down here the other way. And he doing everything, both of y'all doing everything so effortless.
Like, we used to practice this. I remember, like, we were in San Antonio practicing this. Like, not practice, just practicing, trying to figure out dunks and just throwing stuff around. We were just throwing, I'll never forget, just throwing off walls. San Antonio old practice facility, just throwing stuff off walls, just trying to come up with ideas. And that's how, but that night I scrapped it. So I didn't, at this point, I had no idea what I was going to do. No idea.
Man, this is
so
crazy.
You see me, that you see me back there, I'm walking around thinking, I
What's
am
next?
Really like, what are we going to do? Oh, they said, okay, I didn't use a teammate in the first round, so I had to use one in the second round. I'm talking about the fourth, round one. So in round two. So I was just like, all right, what I'm going to do? I don't know.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Because Matt did that, so I was like, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm still lost.
You'd have made
I'm still,
that one first.
This, right now, I'm still lost and don't know what to do. But in my mind, I don't want to miss a dunk. And then all of a sudden, in between this moment here, I remember seeing in East Bay book, the between the legs picture. And I'm
shout
like,
out
all right,
East Bay.
Shout out to East Bay. They got a lot of options.
Something spectacular. Oh, it's over.
And see,
what
we didn't even see
come
the first
down and hit him with the...
It was just reaction.
And then the
all of this
over.
Happened was just reaction. That just, it was, okay, honestly, because, okay, I think I told
you
this before.
What are you thinking when Zeke do that? That's Isaiah Thomas running ahead and jump over bruh, the table and bow
at,
down.
Going
to
wild,
you, bro.
So I think after the dunk happened and I made it, I was thanking the dunk gods. Like, bro, I am making this up and I'm completing these dunks. Oh, it's over. I didn't know which way to do it. I didn't know how high I created that stank in the dunk gods. And then when I'm like, in my mind from that, I'm like, now I'm like, bro, it's over. I'm creating stuff and making them?
Oh
no,
God.
It's over.
After Zeke didn't bow down to you, like, now you walk, it's a minute, it's 2 minutes. And the crowd is, the whole building is buzzing now for the rest of the game. The rest of the dunk, like, how did that feel when you see, like, your peers, the Shaqs, the KGs, everybody standing up going crazy, you got cameras, like, what are you thinking in that moment?
So it's two things. I'm like a kid because I'm in the moment. Like, I dreamed of being here. So I'm rooting for everybody. I want everybody best. I didn't allow myself to really get caught up to, like, what it was, because at the same time, Q, remember, I'm still trying to figure out what's going to come up next. So I'm really, like, this is all up front. You see me walking, like, I'm trying to figure out what. I had already gone over to Antoine asking him for suggestions and KG for suggestions, bro. I'm like, what you got?
You had just ruined the dunk contest. The crowd didn't even respond. Like, Steve Francis just did a nice, like, a win. They didn't even respond. They still got the between the legs on their back. Yo, they didn't even respond to his dunk just then. The crowd said nothing. They still so buzz about what you just did.
That's just so crazy. So I'm trying to figure out, all right, they buzzing. Let me see what Matt gonna do. Cause he's like, all right, I'm gonna do this. This the windmill to the side. And see, this is what young dudes don't, that, see what he did right there? A lot of these young dudes don't do that. They still, if you don't feel like it's a good pass or a good dunk, don't waste your attempt.
They're still trying to go crazy.
You lose the wow factor. If he would have missed that dunk and you saw that, you'd be like, oh, yeah. I didn't know what's happening. So that's what I'm going to say about my first attempt between the legs. Like, I'm like, when he threw the first one, it was a little too low. I just caught it and stopped. I didn't even finish it. I didn't practice because I didn't want you thinking or have no clue what you was about to see. So now, right here, I walk over. Easy. Right. So right here, I walk over to Cat. Right before this, I said, I'm about to try to put my arm inside the whole rim. look at their face.
Bruh, they don't really understand. Like, they like, he just, what? This man just put his whole thing on arm in the rim. Like, look. You got Batman, Michael Keaton out there tripping, bro. This is crazy. I'm talking about, bro. You remember, I'm in college now. I'm ready to get, you know, I'm in college this year doing all this.
Right.
Like, I can't believe what I'm seeing.
Man, so I want to say, like, people were talking about, oh, did I take this from, like, I found out later Kobe did this. I got this idea from I was playing in Gary Payton's All-Star game. And in the layup line, I was jumping over the rim, dropping it in. Oh, I'm going to tell you why I'm like that, because I'm glad I didn't fall off the rim. That's why I was like that. Whew, thank you, Lord, I didn't fall off. But I was jumping up, dropping over the rim, so I was like, maybe I should try to hang. So when I got out there, I said, all right, what I want to do? I'm trying to take all this from the walk to the rim. You see, I look at it, I rub my arm, I walk back. I'm like, I'm going to hold on, and I want it to be quiet. So I held on as long as I could, and I pulled myself off and come up. It didn't hurt until the next morning. It was perfect. It wasn't even black.
Ooh, I know.
I couldn't bend my arm. I couldn't straighten.
You messed up the dunk contest. Steve Franchise just took, he took a seat in midair. He's 6'2". Bang that thing. They ain't even moved back. You got the whole, all the voters, everybody messed up.
Oh,
that would have been crazy going to the other side like that. And see, this back when your attempt, miss or not,
that was it.
You getting a score off that. You can't go 50 times at it. Like,
come with it or go home. Point, and see, now I'm lost. Like, I keep saying every dunk I was lost. They told me that I was done. I didn't have to do a dunk. Then all of a sudden, they come back and said, you have to get you need an official dunk. So I had already, when you said I was done, I did the job. I turned the creative side off.
Right.
Then it was like, oh, wait a minute. You gotta do something. And then somebody whispered, you just need to make a dunk, basically. So that's why I was just like, bro, I'm lost. I ain't know what to do. I tell you, it I hate seeing this dunk. I hate it because what I wanted and what came out of it, I didn't.
This wasn't your cherry on top for you?
No.
This didn't put the cherry on top for you?
No. Nope. I just needed to, and it's just, look at it, it's just like, it just.
It still was the sickest dunk contest. Like,
facts. I just, it didn't satisfy me. I think more than anybody, you know. I do, and I allowed myself to say, I only need 42. You see what I'm saying? Instead of like, let me cut the head off, which that was my thought in the first four dunks.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And so that's where I'm not satisfied with it. So I always like when people show the dunk contest, I'm like, yeah, show the first four. Don't show this. Because it just makes my skin crawl.
So what was it like for you, like, that night afterwards, you know, being in at All-Star Weekend? Like, how did that night and the next week just go? Because that thing was, viral wasn't even a thing back then, and you went viral.
I look forward to being a part of All-Star Saturday all my life, which is crazy. Like, everybody said, I want to be an All-Star, which is true. I was leading vote getter, which is true. But I wanted to be, like, I always recorded the dunk contest, and I wanted to be a part of that moment more than anything. And not only to be there, when I first walked in that arena late in all, I was like, man, I'm here, bro.
Right.
I'm here. Like, practice that.
Practice
receiving that
like
token
that
from the commissioner. And in my mind, I'm gripping this trophy like, bro, don't drop this joke.
Yeah.
Don't drop it. Like, all of these things going through my mind.
Now, how dope was that one moment right there? Like, you saying that's something you done watched over and over, your dudes you look up to. You done practice that moment, and now it's a reality. You in the middle of All-Star Weekend in that moment, and you holding it, and everybody going crazy, you turning around.
Bro, he answered the question, and I was talking. I answered the questions, but I really wasn't there. I was like, okay. Got it. I was like, it was great. Yeah, I did the dunk. First time doing it between the legs, cool. Hold it up. And I was like, okay, hold it. Take the street smile. Oh, yeah, they turned. I'm going off of what I've seen and what I practiced, what Dr. J did. So, and the reason I throw Dr. J's name out of there, so I'm holding it. All my boys, we all sitting there. It was only two of us. I said all my boys. And then Matt, it was really four of us. We walking out. I'm holding the trophy. And you know that arena. You know, it had the curtain to go back into the locker room. Pull the curtain back. It was like a movie. First person standing there is who? Dr. J.
You lost it.
My hero.
Yo. Right.
Like, what? I just held a trophy, been watching. My hero is standing there. Congratulations, young fella. Like, what? What? Man, so not only did that happen, I was like, Doc, man, appreciate it. Do you mind? Would you mind taking a picture with me with the trophy? He's like, let's go. So we go. I had to take all the pictures for the NBA, right. Whatever. Doc, right there, took
Gangster,
pictures with
me. Like, bro, I was like, with you.
Yeah, it was like everything that a kid could dream of. Like, oh, I'm gonna make it to the NBA and I'm gonna play against Mike. You know what? How we thought about it coming up. I'm gonna play against Mike. That was kind of my moment, you know. I mean, that was one of my moments too, because I knew I was going to see Doc, but I was like, I want to play against Mike. I got a chance to play against Mike,
right?
head to head, I got a chance to be in the dunk contest and win it, and my hero was there to congratulate me. Like,
life is made, right there.
And you asked the question about what it did for me the weeks past, like. It first of all, it put Toronto on the map as far as giving us recognition because of not only what I did, T-Mac did his thing.
Straight up.
Then got to play in the All-Star game that next day. So it just gave me confidence that I belong. And it gave Toronto, the city, like it gave, we got, shortly thereafter, we got our first nationally televised game.
Right, yeah.
Against Phoenix.
CTV.
And I got my career high shortly thereafter. I got my career high. So, and then the Olympics happens that summer. So.
And it's out of here.
Go from there.
All right, man. That was dope, man. Checking out the 2000 Legendary Dunk Contest with the main man, Ben Saturday, Air Canada. Half man, half amazing. And like that dunk contest was, this is over.
That's right. I wanted to give him a 12. I wanted to give him a 12. We need another scoring system. He's amazing. Wow. Yes, sir.